Have you ever thought that you would know when you will get hypercholesterolemia, or high cholesterol for that matter, or that all the types of cholesterol are bad? So there are a lot of myths and questions that surround hypercholesterolemia. That is what we'll try to do in this video, and we'll try to debunk some of those myths right before you. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Dr. Shoaib, and I'm one of the nephrologists and internal medicine doctors at Cambridge University Hospital. Before we start debunking those myths, I would like to request you to please subscribe this channel and also press the bell icon so that you are the first person to know about videos such as these. So the first myth being, you would know when you'll get hypercholesterolemia. It's usually next to impossible to know how much cholesterol you have in your blood, unless or until you happen to be a running biochemistry lab yourself. But there are some signs or features that could actually help you find if you've got hypercholesterolemia. Features like angina, gangrene, heart attack for that matter, or stroke. These are some of the advanced features or clinical signs that a patient can actually get. But by the time a patient gets these, it's already too late. There are some signs or features that could actually help detect hypercholesterolemia. And one of these is xanthomas. So these are these growths that are visible in patients with hypercholesterolemia. But again, unfortunately, by the time xanthomas develop, the patient already has a very high cholesterol level in their blood. So it goes without saying that if you have a hunt or a hunch that you might be having hypercholesterolemia, you should go to your clinical physician and mention that so that they can actually run some blood tests on you. Now, the second myth is all cholesterol is bad cholesterol. Now, cholesterol is an important component in your body, and your liver basically helps you make cholesterol. Cholesterol is used in cell membranes, it's used to make vitamin D, and also in several other functions like hormonal functions in your body. Now, the cholesterol, or basically lipids for that matter, usually move in your body in combination with proteins. They are called lipoproteins. And there are two basic types of lipoprotein that we come across every day. The first type is called LDL or low density lipoproteins, and the second is HDL or high density lipoproteins. The LDL or low density lipoproteins, their job is to take a lot of cholesterol or fat and take them to the cell essentially, so that some cell functions can actually work. While the high density lipoproteins, they take excess cholesterol from the cells and away from the cells into the liver, where basically they are degraded. The problem comes when there is a lot of LDL or excess of LDL compared to HDL, and that's where basically the hypercholesterolemia starts to behave odd. So the bottom line is, not all cholesterol is bad. HDL is your friendly cholesterol type, but we got to keep an eye on the LDL and VLDL because they are the bad ones. The third myth is, we need to have the same cholesterol targets for everyone. Now, the usual targets for a hypercholesterolemia are about 200 milligrams per deciliter for total cholesterol, and about 100 milligrams per deciliter if you're talking about the LDL type. But that's not the same for every patient. Now, if a patient has got high risk factors, like a family history of hypercholesterolemia with a heart disease, stroke for that matter, or they are smokers or drinking a lot, then the targets for them need to be adjusted. So make sure you sit down with your doctor and discuss about these targets, because probably you might need an even lower target for you. Now, the fourth myth is, women usually don't have to worry about hypercholesterolemia. Now, that's not true, because heart disease, as per CDC, usually does not discriminate a lot between men and women. Pregnancy, breastfeeding, menopause, and some hormonal changes. These are some of the conditions where women sometimes might have slightly more or less risk compared to men based on what they're going through. But regardless, usually the cholesterol and the conditions associated with it, they affect more or less both the men and women equally. Now, another myth is, all you need is a good exercise and diet regimen, and that's it. You can conquer your cholesterol by that. It's not wrong to say that in general, but obesity, smoking, alcohol, and genetic history, factors such as these also play an important role. Now, the sixth myth is, medications are enough. Usually, the type of medications that are given in a patient with hypercholesterolemia are called statins. And statins do help to minimize the production of cholesterol by liver. But there are two ways hypercholesterolemia can actually affect you. The first way is your liver produces a lot of cholesterol. The second is how much cholesterol you eat. In a study in 2014 of about 27,000 participants, it was found that when they were started on statins, their intake of fat or high calorie diet actually increased, which is not the right thing. Taking a well-balanced diet and at the same time keeping a check on your BMI is the key basically in cholesterol management. Now, another myth is patients do think that they are young, they are under 40, physically fit, so they don't need to basically worry about hypercholesterolemia. The American Heart Association disagrees with you. And the reason is that they do expect that there is a chance, even if you're young, that you might end up getting hypercholesterolemia. So what they recommend is getting yourself tested. Usually, if from 9 to 11 years age, you should get tested at least once. The same way from 17 to 21 age, you should get tested one more time. And after 20 years of age, you should at least get tested every 5 years. Now, CDC also recommends if you've got diabetes, you're a smoker, you drink, or you've got a family history of heart disease, that you should basically get tested more frequently than this. Now, in conclusion, hypercholesterolemia usually increases the risk of heart disease and stroke in patients in conditions like these, but your doctor usually does not look at a single number. But they have to look at a lot of factors, including the risk factors that you might have other than a cholesterol number in your blood. Healthy lifestyle, regular monitoring, and taking your medications when they are given on time is basically the key to success here. There you go, the top 7 cholesterol-related myths debunked. Now, if you like content such as this one, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and also press the bell icon, as this will help me make more of these videos. Now, until next time, take care of yourself and everyone around you. I will see you again with another one of these videos. Allah Hafiz.